Keisha, thank you. Governor Mark Sanford was in the Upstate today to attend a grand opening of two new companies. He said South Carolina has benefited from the economic slowdown in this country, with more companies deciding to move their operations here. News 4's Tim Waller spoke to the governor this morning, and Tim, you asked him specifically about jobs in the state?
Yeah, Nigel, basically we wanted to know if the job creation, and we saw some of that a little bit earlier today, is keeping up with the demand for jobs. Now, the two companies that Governor Sanford visited today will bring about 100 jobs to the Upstate. More jobs, they say, are on the way, but will they get here soon enough?
So this is the general layout. I'll take you around and show you some of the machinery.
From an economic standpoint, the addition of companies like CFS Logistics, a supplier to BMW, is reason for celebration.
I mean, you go to other states, they just don't understand what it takes to get people to come and open a factory.
It's a company that chose South Carolina over other states because of what the vice president describes as a pro-business climate.
This state needs to be a model because, again, we don't need bailouts. We need people to build things. And if you provide a platform for people to want to build things here, there are jobs.
The company has brought about 75 jobs and $12 million in investment to the Upstate. Governor Mark Sanford, here for the tour, says more companies are likely to follow.
South Carolina has in many ways benefited from the economic slowdown. I mean, it's been painful, again, for a lot of folks. It's been painful for a lot of families. But in terms of consolidations within industries, in many cases, South Carolina has benefited relative to other states.
But with the state's unemployment rate still at 10% and many of the jobless on extended benefits, the governor said many of the jobs being created now will require retraining to get people back to work.
I think it reiterates that larger importance of our education should never end in life, that we should constantly be in that business of retraining and retooling ourselves.
The governor's second stop in the Upstate to tour today was at Independent Pipe Products in Abbeville. That company will employ about 25 people and bring with it a $9 million investment. Kim?